Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to do a live repair on a fine grain quartz top, one of the hardest repairs there is out there. We're going to introduce a game changer to you today by the name of Polishing Gantry QR5. We're basically bringing all the luxuries of a shop into the house to make polishing that much easier and your success rate that much higher. A couple things you have in the shop that you don't have in the field typically would be a water feed. So we've introduced a water feed that's totally self-contained. We're running water through our polisher. It's emptying out into a container. We don't have to worry about it. The other thing is we're self-flowing with our polishing. We can literally polish with one hand now. Okay. For those of you that have polished face polish in the field, you know one of the biggest challenges is to maintain that constant pressure. Especially when your repair becomes very big. It's very tough to keep your finish even because your pressure is constantly changing. And anyone that does any kind of polishing knows that that's really hard on your shoulders. Now that has been eliminated as well. Like I say, you can literally polish with one hand. Okay, so we're going to show you a close-up of our before picture. We basically come in, like many of the repairs that I do, to a scratch, started as a scratch. Someone came in to try to remove the scratch, and now we have a large hazy area on a big island, as you can see, with a very even finish. It's a very tough repair. So we want all the advantages we can have, and this really is a game changer when it comes to making that happen. Okay, what I didn't mention the first time around is that the gantry is very stable. That noise that you may hear is the air compressor running. It's actually vacuumed down to the top, which makes this polisher very perfectly level with the top wherever I go. Okay, so I wanted you to get a before shot of the damage that we're working with. This, like I mentioned, started as a pretty deep scratch. The scratch was not totally removed, and now we're getting the rest of the scratch out and trying to feather everything out and get back to our factory finish. So I'm marking everything off just like I normally would, polishing by hand. Okay, so I have to get the remainder of my scratching out and then start feathering out and moving up in grits. Okay, so we're going to continue with our polishing operation. Again, we're still on 500, the NSI pads. We're using the snail lock, so in this case, when my polisher is raised up from the surface, I can just remove my snail lock without actually removing the polisher. But I can easily remove the polisher from here if I need to. Okay, so this is after my first pass of 500 with the NSI pads. I have a couple spots marked, as you can see there in blue. I'm going to do another pass over those just because there's some marks that I don't know that 1,000 will get out, so I'm going to go do another pass with that. But this is just give you an idea of where we're at. And the one thing that really stands out from here, this might be hard to see in the video, is that I really don't have much of a halo. And if I were doing this by hand, not only would it take me longer, but I would definitely have a halo, or would be fighting to not have one. So as you can see, the gloss level is pretty good at this point for 500 level. So like I say, I'm gonna make that another quick pass with 500 to get those marks out. And then I'm going to be working up to 1,000. Okay, now that I've finished with my 500 level, I've carefully marked off the outside perimeter of my polishing area, and now I'm moving up to 1000 NSI pad. Again, using the snail lock, I can just change this without removing the polisher. Okay, so I finished my 1000 grit process. I did two passes just like I did with 500, just to get it as even as I could and get some of the corn rowing out, stuff like that. But you can see it, my gloss level is pretty good at this point. Okay, and my initial scratch is long gone. It's just a matter of blending in with the factory now. So the same process that I would typically use now, we're going to proceed with that, moving into the Quartz Renew pads, which those of you who haven't tried those, they're intended for lower risk than a resin pad, and they get out all this, a lot of this fine hazing that you see, be the medium damage type of repair. You can start with that type of pad, and more like a 1000 to 3000 grit range. Okay, so let's give you a quick look of the repair area here. Okay, so we've gone to the 1000 grit NSI floating pad. Gotten our sheen pretty high. We still have some cut marks here or there, very minor stuff. As we go into the next phase of polishing, we're going to go into the Quartz Renew pads, which is a diamond mesh pad that been out for a couple years now, and I've had a lot of success with them. They were designed for polishing in the field by hand at a lower risk because they're a flexible sandpaper type pad. The risk of dipping and so forth was minimized, and traditionally we didn't have to use these with a water feed, and that's really the same case. They stay wet very well, so even with this, in this case we have a water feed, I'm just going to wet the top and cut the water feed off because I really don't need it to keep going, and the pad will stay wet the whole time. So in this case, this is a four-step process. Like I said, is more of like maybe a 850 to 3000 range, roughly. I'm gonna start at the number three pad in this process because I have a pretty good gloss level at this point, and I really just need to start getting the minor haze spots out. So there's really not a need for me to start at 1000 or the number one pad, which is a little more aggressive. So in the case of just so you know when to use this type of pad, if you have a scratch that you can't feel with your fingernail, this is kind of the starting point for you. In this case, we had a scratch that was still there. You could definitely feel with your fingernail. So we need something that's going to hog out material and make a little more quick work of that material removal. So that's why we started with the NSI pads. So in this case, we start there, then we go to the Quartz Renew pads, and then we're going to finish up with the Quartz Renew, which will blend in with our with the rest of our finish, with our factory finish. Okay, so here's a shot after the number three pad, the Quartz Renew number three pad, which did do a good job of stepping up the finish slightly over the 1000 that I was using before. So you can get a good look of where we are at this point. You can see the edge of our repair area is right about here. Okay, and there's really no halo to speak of. And you can subtly tell where the polishing ends, but not with a stark, hazy line like you would typically get with traditional hand polishing. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and move to the number 4 Quartz Renew pad and keep moving in the process. And the water pump obviously is feeding our polisher. Both of those have been combined into one unit and are actually attached to the frame at this point. So it's much more compact, there's less pieces involved, and very easy and efficient to use. So as far as wrapping up the unit, putting it back in the case, the gantry locks in place for transport. So on the side there are set screws that hold the gantry in place, keep it from sliding on the rails on both sides. And on the center to hold everything in place. So as far as folding the unit to put it back in the case, the sides simply fold in. Okay. And it's freestanding, so it goes back into the carrying case as you see. Okay, so I've finished my Quartz Renew polishing. I've removed the polishing gantry from the surface, and now I'm going to move into my final stage, which is the Quartz Renew polishing process. Now, for those of you that are familiar with the process, you know that the first step is the snakeskin revealer, which has to do with texture. And in this type of fine grain surface, texture is really not much of an issue here, so we're going to be focusing primarily on getting the rest of the hazing out and blending in. So we're going to be focusing on the second and third steps only. But so here's a kind of an overall shot of where we are in our polishing process. You can see we've got a little bit of striping there from our polishing back and forth, which I'm not too concerned about. Our hazing is pretty subtle, but is certainly noticeable. So now we will be trying to blend that out. Okay, so we're moving into our final phase using the Quartz Renew. Like I mentioned, we really don't have a texture issue here, so the first step of the snakeskin revealer we're not going to use in this case. We're focused on the hazing and getting that out and blending with our factory. So I'm starting with the number 2 resin polish, and for those of you familiar with the resin polish, comes as a green tint and separates, so you want to shake that really well and put that down. You can use this as many times as you need to. I expect the hazing to come out about 85% or so, maybe 90%. It will not get you all the way in most cases. That will be the final polish phase for that. This gets applied with a green foam pad, and we're going to run our RPMs all the way down. And basically the same process as our diamond polishing. We're going to go with a slow feed rate, meaning moving very slowly across the surface, going side to side, front to back. Wipe it off, check to see how you look. If you're not happy with where you are and you see some inconsistencies, do another pass. It won't hurt the surface.
Okay, so we finished the number two resin polish of the Quartz Renew. And just give you a quick look at the area here. So we do still have some hazing that we have to get out. Try to capture some of that. As you can see on the little bit of a halo right there. But coming along pretty nicely. Now we just want to move to the final polish and blend in with the factory finish. Okay, so there's our final finish after the number three final polish phase of the Quartz Renew. See our original area and our final finish.